alone and tragically bored for all eternity. I can't think of nothing more unacceptable. Oh, let's run it. Hey everybody, before this video starts, I want to remind everyone that everything you see here was previously streamed live. Make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon for notifications when we do go live. You can become a member and rewatch any archive broadcast that drastically helps support the channel. Make sure you also join a Discord and follow me on Twitter and Instagram at AMSLabs for all updates on the channel. Enjoy the video.
Hey there.
Alright, so...
I'm curious to see how.
Who are you?
If you insist on an answer, then you may better know me as Dr. Stanislaus Braun.
I've chosen a different appearance for myself here, in my own little playground.
What am I supposed to be doing again?
Rock.
I don't really want to do that.
Have you met Doc the dog? He's another new arrival, much like yourself. He might seem a bit. familiar to you, huh?
Wait, what?
Look forward to seeing how you deal with
I don't think he's gonna give me an option there. The dog? Oh, hi, Dad. Dad, is that really you? Huh.
Hey.
Hey.
Good day to you.
Anything going to tell me about your marriage?
Our marriage? Well, goodness, what kind of a question is that?
Whew.
Mabel didn't put you up to this, did she? What a silly thing to ask about.
I'm gonna talk to Mabel.
Well, hi there.
God damn it. Press the wrong button. When your hands aren't on WASD and instead on E.
Good day. Well, hi there.
What does this look like? This stuff off. Interesting. I'm playing around with some things. Just for fun. Just no other reason. Actually, I may have broke the ENP. Oh well. We'll have to reload the game after this. Anything you want to tell me about your marriage?
Now see here. That's not anything for you to be asking about. Our marriage is our business and it's private. Why can't people just understand that and just leave us alone?
Bum, bum, bum. Let me try this again. Hang on. Is it really broken or is that just like a weird glitch? No, it broke. I broke it. That's funny. I broke the NB. Oh well. We'll fix that in a minute. We'll fix it later. Easy fix.
What can I do for you, sport?
Where am I?
Such a kidder. You're on Tranquility Lane, of course. Where else would you be?
This is what, some kind of computer simulation?
Sounds like you've been spending too much time with your nose in those darned comic books, sport. Their marriage? Why, that's an odd sort of question. They're like anyone else, I suppose. Got their problems, but they work through them. Janet's a good woman. It's a good thing that Roger came to his senses.
Roger came to his senses, huh? I want to find this Mabel. God damn it.
Good day.
I don't really want to use a speech check because I feel like that's too easy. Abandoned house? Oh. I want to go inside the abandoned house. Oh my god. That is amazing. I had no idea he had a watch. That's awesome. What'd this do? I activated a gnome. That's fine, right? Did all the gnomes do something? Because I punched that one gnome. Is nobody in here? Damn, I was hoping I could turn that on. Well, this looks like there's much I can do here. Signal found.
Henderson Estate is in tip-top shape, young master. Have a wonderful day.
Why, thanks, Codsworth. I'm having fun. Damn it. I'm not finding much other many other options to do here. Aha, here we go. Who are you?
You don't belong here. You're not supposed to be here. It's not real, none of it. It needs to end. The suffering must end.
Finally, someone knows what's going on. How do I get out of here?
We're not really here. We're not really talking. It's all made up. Make believe. We're sleeping, dreaming. Dream became a nightmare. It has to end. It just has to. But we're not in charge. He is. And he doesn't want us to wake up.
Who are you talking about?
He calls himself Betty now, but he's still the same. He can put on a new face all he likes, but underneath he's still evil. Braun. Bastard thinks because he helped create this place, he's God here. But I know he still uses the fail-safe terminal. I know it.
What failsafe? What the hell are you talking about?
It's in the abandoned house. He doesn't want us going in there because he's afraid we might find it. It's the only terminal to the outside. The only way to shut the whole thing down. You've got to find it.
All right. I'm going right for it. After I talk to Betty one more time.
I'm curious to see.
Who are you?
You know that I am Dr. Braun. Anything else is irrelevant. Perhaps you should.
Nah, I'm good. I'm just gonna go straight to the abandoned house and figure it out. Thank you, though. I was actually here a minute ago and I activated a gnome. Don't know what that did. I go upstairs earlier? Does that say my bed? No, it just says bed. Okay. I thought that said my bed for a minute. I was like, whoa. Oh. What? All right, hang on. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. There's one I'm missing then. There's another thing I can touch that I'm missing. There's another option here that I don't know where it is. Where's this last option at? Is it upstairs? Yeah, that's nasty. fucking puzzles. I don't see another option. Wait. Hang on, I got it. Boom, 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 boom. Ha 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 ha! Figured it out. There's a pattern there. It's boom, 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 boom. It jumped back to every other one. I finally come to the realization that this Toucan Lounge simulation has run its course. I'm tired of beaten sun and ceaseless pounding of the lagoon's waves upon the shore. I no longer take pleasure in watching Simpson wither away from scurvy or hearing news Bossom's screams as he devours by the Mako shark. I'm quite simply bored. It's time to reset the simulation once again. I haven't been skiing in ages. Yesterday, Doc Dithers slipped on one of the chalet's icy stairs. Went airborne and managed to impale herself on the route iron fence. It was spectacular and completely and utterly random. Is there anything more sublime than the bold crimson of fresh fallen snow? It was almost enough to make me reconsider a change of scenery, but not quite. 23 years is a long vacation in the Swiss Alps. I long for something more domestic. I have surprised myself. I find Tranquility Lane comforting, although distinctly American. It somehow reminds me of Kronark, the town of my childhood. There's a beautiful irony with this particular simulation as well. The residents here are naturally at home, naturally safe. When I toy with them, when their suburban illusion is suddenly broken, it's that much more satisfying. I do believe we shall remain here in Tranquility Lane for a long time. A very long time indeed. Let's play version notes. Spectate, whoa. Access Chinese invasion program. There are days I consider finally pulling the plug, as it were, and putting a permanent end to both the simulation and my life. That is the reason I requested the installation of General Chase's Chinese invasion program, after all. By disabling the safety protocols, I have ensured that each subject in Vault 112 will physically die if they're in simulation avatars are killed. Real-world death and the simulation, the perfect failsafe. At least it would have been if not for my own misjudgment. I knew when the simulation first went online that the secondary safeties those established for all Vault Tech and military personnel would prevent my own real-world demise in the event of failsafe execution. In the end, I would kill the subjects and save myself. I wouldn't want it any other way, or so I thought. It's true that the failsafe would scare the living hell out of every resident in Tranquility Lane and lead to their brutal deaths, but then what about me? I had no ability to disable my own safety from within the simulation, and any other avatars I could create would be driven by the simulation's AI routines, not actually living, thinking human subjects. What was the fun of tormenting a machine? And so, the release of the real-world subjects is more than they deserve, more than I could bear. They'd be dead, and I'd be left in Tranquility Lane, alone and tragically bored for all eternity. I can't think of nothing more unacceptable. Well, let's run it. Gained karma. I killed everybody. Gained karma. Oh boy.
Do you realize what you've done? You've triggered the failsafe, ruined everything. The subjects will die, and I'll be stuck here in this hell alone.
You ruined everything. Everything.
Well, I'm calling the shots now.
You? No, I am the creator of this world.
Feels so lost. So all alone.
Tell me about the Gek.
The Garden of Eden creation kit. It was for terraforming, for restoring the world after a nuclear disaster. Unstable technology, and ultimately boring. Why remake the old reality when instead you could create any reality you choose?
I came here for my father, now where is he?
Didn't you figure it out, huh? The dog. So loyal, so trusting. So annoying.
I simply made him what he always was.
I mean, we kind of know that. So my father is okay? I can get him back?
Yes, I'm sure he's fine. No doubt, when you leave the simulation, he'll be waiting for you.
But there's no one waiting for me.
So I'm free to leave now.
Isn't it obvious? You've run the failsafe, disrupted everything. I have no power over you.
There's the door. Go.
All right, I have to go.
Run along now.
All right, let's go. Activate exit. And now we're gonna have to change some things around here because we kind of fucked this game up. Gonna be fucked. Isn't like a future game? You come back and you're just like, oh yeah, Bronn is still in this fucking thing. And that's like a mission. You have to save Bronn, so you have to go to Capital Wasteland and do so. That'd be fucked. All right, everything's back going. And there he is, the man of the hour.
So, you've saved me. I was afraid I'd be trapped in there forever. It's so good to see you, but what are you doing here?
I want answers from you.
You came all this way and risked your life for answers. It must be important to you.
What the hell is wrong with you? Why did you just leave me like that?
That's where you belonged. You were an adult, capable of fending for yourself, and you had a good life ahead of you. What's out here is my task, my responsibility. I never wanted you to have any part of this insanity.
Your responsibility? What does that mean?
Project Purity was underway long before you were born. There were many of us, including your mother, who devoted our lives to it. The idea of free, clean water for everyone drove us to succeed. So many sacrifices were made for that idea. My responsibility is to see it through to the end, to make sure those sacrifices mean something.
What about me? What am I supposed to do?
Yes, what about you? Why, in fact, are you outside the vault at all? I don't even want to know how you got out. As much as I appreciate your help, you were supposed to stay there, to make a life for yourself there, not out here.
I didn't really have a choice. You left there without saying goodbye. What was I supposed to do?
You were supposed to stay put. You could have had a good life in the vault. But I suppose it's too late to go back now, isn't it? The Overseer would likely have a shot on sight. Well then, you'll just have to come with me to Rivet City. You've certainly proven yourself capable enough.
I'm not going with you. I had everything to take care of.
Really? You're not going to join me?
No, I will, just not right now.
This way after me, I'd have thought you'd want to help. I have to keep going. I can't stop now. I'm going back to Rivet City. Meet me there if you change your mind. It would be good to work with you, son.
Can we just talk for a minute?
Of course, son. What's on your mind?
First off, can we all appreciate how terrible that writing was? He's like, you should have stayed there. You should have been there. I'm mad. Wouldn't it be nice to work with you, though? How could you just leave me like that? What the hell were you thinking?
I wanted you to be safe. I didn't want this for you. A life out here in this godforsaken war zone. I couldn't tell you what I was doing because I didn't want you following me. A plan which clearly was not as successful as I imagined it would be.
Is this about Mom? Are you trying so hard because of what happened to her?
Oh, my son. If only you could have known how much it meant to her. She believed in the work we were doing and was so determined to see it through. She gave up so much for this project. We all did. And I don't want that to have been for nothing.
I just see his Pip-Boy. I think I understand. I'm glad we talked.
Oh, my son. While this isn't what I had in mind, it's good to have you with me.
Guys, this is terrible writing. So, how did Mom really die?
I understand that you have reason to question a good many things I've told you over the years. But your mother... I've never lied to you about what happened. Not once. She died giving birth to you. It was a difficult time. She was so eager to meet you, to make a place for you in the world. If nothing else, please believe that she loved you very much.
She loved me for like 5 minutes. What exactly is this Project Purity?
It started as an idea, really. Remember the Bible passage your mother loves so much? Free, clean water for everyone. What a difference it could make in the lives of everyone here in the Wastes. Over time, that idea took the form of a purifier. Not like the one in the vault, though. This one was gigantic, capable of purifying millions of gallons of water at once. We used the old Jefferson Memorial for the location, right on DC's tidal basin. Someday soon, I hope you'll see it work.
Okay, so what happened to Project Purity?
In the year before you were born, things became difficult. There had always been something of a mutant problem in the city, but it became worse. They attacked more frequently and more aggressively. Support for the project eroded as time went on, when we couldn't produce any significant results. Progress came to a halt. And then you were born. Your mother and I had talked about what to do when that time came, but then we lost her, and I had to make a decision. I chose to leave. From what I understand, things happened quickly after that. It became too dangerous for the others to stay, and so the project was abandoned. Dr. Lee and her team left for what became Rivet City, and Project Purity has sat waiting ever since.
I wanted to talk to you about some things.
What's on your mind?
Can we just go back to the vault and back to the way things were?
Somehow, I don't think the Overseer would agree with that. What's done is done. But if we succeed, if we can make Project Purity a reality, we can create a new life for ourselves out here.
Why would you throw away the life we had?
You have to understand, the vault wasn't for me. It was for you. To make sure my son grew up someplace safe, away from all this. I didn't want you to leave. I wanted you to stay there, to grow up and live your life in safety.
Just forget, let's get this over with.
I hope that you can understand why I've done the things that I've done. The last thing I want is to lose my son.
What's the big deal about water anyway?
The vault you grew up in had its own water purification system. Clean water was never a worry. Out here, things are different. Water out here is never clean, and almost always irradiated. It's barely able to sustain any kind of normal life. If we can change that, humanity has a real chance at rebuilding. Starting over.
Alright. Have to go, Dad.
Careful, my son.
Okay. I forgot what Johnny Bildick looks like. What a fucking stud, dude. Thank you for watching. Like the video if you haven't already. Subscribe for more content. Comment down below and check the description for links such as the Discord.